trucks will be on our way. Headed off to Madagascar. There's the ball. We're going to catch a glimpse of our two blue-eyed black lemurs, hopefully. They're just on the grass here outside. We've got Belle and we've got Rabu. Now we're going to talk about lemurs and Madagascar a little bit more later on. Our next set of animals have got a house on the left and a paddock in the right, but I think everybody's indoors at the moment. Ah yes, there they are. Keep an eye out for the big, hairy, handsome beast in there as well. His name is Malachi. These are our geladas, the last surviving species of the ancient grass-grazing primates, all the way from the slopes and cliffs of Ethiopia. And they've developed really nice padded bottoms, those geladas, which keeps them comfortable during their day, pretty much spent just eating grasses, shuffling around. It's all very civilised. The yellow building there on the right-hand side, that's home to our new world monkeys, the marmosets and the tamarins. And you'll find the smallest one in there, the white-bellied pygmy, coming in at a very cute 11 centimetres long. Travel a bit further north though, to the west coast of America, and you'll find Californian sea lions. We've got four of them at the bay just on the left-hand side, and the keepers do put them through their training exercises periodically throughout the day. Over to the coasts of Africa next. To the right-hand side, you'll find black-footed penguins and some of their friends, the spoonbills and the egrets. See, not all penguins live and breed on the ice of Antarctica. In fact, of the 18 different species of penguin, only four actually do, including our favourites, of course, the emperor penguin. Other penguins are found from the western coasts of South America, right round to the southern coasts even now of Australia and New Zealand. Still a bit chilly here today. If you're looking to warm up, head into that green building on the right-hand side. That is Eureka, our subtropical paradise, home to free-flying butterflies and birds. But it's also where you'll find our two dwarf caiman, the smallest of all the croc and alligator species. They can hold their breath underwater for just up to an hour. But it's also where you'll find coppery titi monkeys and saki monkeys darting through the undergrowth. And of course our two sloths, Flo and Santos. And if you haven't seen the sloths in Eureka yet, pop back in. Have a look up into the vines. They can be quite well camouflaged from time to time. That is, if they're not motoring across the beams just up above. We've got La Hacienda to the right-hand side, the old farm barn, celebrating our traditions as a working farm. We've got some alpaca in there now to go along with our chinchillas. We've got the cunicoon pigs, the rabbits, the guinea pigs. And if it is your cup of tea, there's also the infamous rat room, of course. But if you've got any questions about your visit with us here today, or if you want to know more about the feeding experiences available, do pop into Zoo HQ there on the left-hand side. Have a chat with the ladies in the guest services. As for us, we're wrapping right round the other side of planet Earth, going down under to the Australian bush. We've certainly got our two gentlemen emu here. We've got Mick and we've got Shane on the left-hand side. But it is also home to our bongos, or kangaroos to you. But I must admit, I haven't seen the kangaroos outside here yet today. It's a bit chilly for them, but hopefully keepers will get them outside soon enough. Otherwise, on the right-hand side, we've been going past a large collection of owls. Again, from across the different continents, from our blue book owls and our African wood owls, the rufous-legged owls. And as we come round the corner, keep an eye out for Dorian, the great grey owl. There he is, just coming up. And also, Harry Potter's snowy owl, Hedwig. To the left-hand side, you'll see our herd of llama in the South American countries again. Places like Peru, where they've been used as pack animals for almost 5,000 years. Llamas are certainly not daft creatures. If they're going on a trek but they think they're carrying too much weight, they will actually just lay down, refusing to move until their load is lightened. Probably the best animal in the world to wake you up, of course, in the morning, a llama. But we're coming into cat territory now, and specifically the cold, arid highlands of the Himalayas, rugged mountains of Central Asia. Have a look up onto the roof of this pink building on the left-hand side, and you'll see our two snow leopards up there. Lady Enif and Mr. Rocky. And this little cold snap that we're going through right now, not a problem for them. Where they're from, temperatures drop down to minus 40. And do keep an eye out for the other big cats we've got here. I can see Kalima, one of our cheetah, just on the left-hand side. We've also got the Sri Lankan leopards, as well as Sveta, the Siberian tiger. And there's Shaka, just down by the fence line there as well, our other cheetah. But over to the right-hand side, please do give a big rookie roar to our three camels. That's the kind of noise they make, a bit like Chewbacca from Star Wars. And those are Bactrian camels from the Central Asian deserts, places like the Gobi Desert. It's dromedary camels that only have one hump, the ones that you might find in Egypt. And those humps, they're not made up of water, as many people think. They're actually made up of fatty deposits. Oh, father and son, Ricky and William on the right-hand side, our two Siamang gibbons on the grass there. They can be pretty vocal in their own rights. Looks like our spider monkeys have gone back inside from the cold. If you haven't seen them yet, head round to the back of their enclosure. You can peer through their windows. They really won't mind. Our Asian small-clawed otters and meerkats to the left. And if you have a look up into the silver birch trees back there, you'll see Jasper right at the very top, one of our red panda. Maggie, his lady, and the little baby that was born earlier this year must be in one of those wooden crates. What we call arboreal creatures, red pandas spend most of their time up in the treetops. But we come back full circle to Madagascar. Over on the left-hand side, lemur encounters. Now this is a walkthrough where you can get just a little bit closer to our gorgeous red ruffed lemurs. It's their territorial shrieking calls you might hear out and about the zoo. But it's also home to our eight cheeky chappies, the ring-tailed lemurs, that I can see just on the left-hand side here on one of their wooden platforms. To keep warm. They were made famous by the film Madagascar, starring good old King Julian. Although in real life, there is a little bit of role reversal because it's the ladies that rule the roost. Even the youngest born girls can boss around the oldest males, especially when it comes to food. And we've got six different species of lemur here at Banham. Out on the island of Madagascar, the only country where lemurs are found natively in the wild, there's almost 100 different species. They're all vying for a little bit of forest called home. But lemur numbers have dropped quite dramatically over the last couple of decades as us humans cut down the trees where they live, taking away their natural habitat. But it's not all doom and gloom. It is a massive thank you to everyone who visits us here. Your entrance fees, not just going towards helping our animals, but also supporting us with a lot of the conservation projects that we're involved with around the world. We've now been able to help buy upland in Madagascar, creating special reserves for these lovely lemurs, hopefully protecting them for generations to come. And that's a big part of what we're involved in, of course, alongside our sister zoo, Africa Alive. Many of the animals that we have at our zoos, they're not just here for us to look at. They're all part of breeding programs. So, for example, Lady Enna from Mr. Rocky are two snow leopards. They're children's children, part of the breeding programs in India. Hopefully their children will be released back out into the wild. Well, there we go. That's the end of our tour there. The next thing going on, 1:30, and the giraffes are getting a bit of a feed in the opposite corner of the zoo.